Now let's come to the text. Verse 1. Come now, ye rich men, weep and howl for your miseries that shall come upon you. Now, there's another problem we must face as we get into this passage. Is he speaking to the rich in his day? The godless rich in his day or some future day? Well, first of all, he is giving a warning to the rich in his day. And it has an application, I think, for any day, and certainly our day. James wrote this epistle, we believe, somewhere between 45 and 50 A.D. Many give the date now as 60 A.D. Well, regardless of the date, the destruction of Jerusalem was in the near future. For in 70 A.D., Titus the Roman came and destroyed Jerusalem as it had never been destroyed before. He plowed it under. He hated Christians and he hated Jews, and they both were in that city. And believe me, when he got through, there were no rich Jews left. They were either killed or had been put in slavery. And all the riches were destroyed or lost or confiscated. And so he can make these strong statements in view of what was coming. The Lord Jesus said that before he left. He said that you're going to see Jerusalem compassed with armies. And it was fulfilled in 70 A.D. Now in verse 2 he says, your riches are corrupted and your garments are moth-eaten. Also in light of the coming of Christ, they are warned that all the riches of the world will come to naught. Now, this obviously would not impress a godless rich person in that day any more than it would today. But he would know that the future is uncertain for him in that day, as many today see it that way. There's a danger of a panic, a crash, a drought, or a depression. And that's been the order of the day since men started to mint money. They have been good years, and they've been bad years. Now, some of us can remember the depression of the early 30s, when millionaires by the score leaped out of the windows of skyscrapers, and many rich found they became paupers overnight. And some former millionaires, they sold apples at street corners. And gilt-edged stocks and bonds and safety deposit boxes were not worth the paper it is written on. Somebody says, how could gold and silver in a safety deposit box, how could it rust? How could you use it? Well, when you got it in gilt-edged stocks, it can turn to just paper. That's all. And that's what it did in that day.